Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Honorable Deputy Chairman of the Committees, my friend, the Honorable Sarath Tamunugama, got very excited about missing offenders from the country. Now, the fact is, there is a difference between offenders and suspects. We know in criminal law, everybody is presumed innocent until he is proven guilty. So, when it comes to suspects, this transfer of offenders law doesn't apply. It's an extradition law. Now, you have to first know, you have a wider picture, I understand. But now the question of extradition is postulated on certain principles. You must first have an extradition treaty. Then you have to lodge a red notice with the Interpol. The Interpol has to inform the recipient state or the state in which the so-called suspect is absconding. It is up to that state to do the law enforcement there and then inform the receiving state and then extradite the suspect. So this whole process has to take place. So in morning, the Honorable Prime Minister, in reply to Dr. Jayathissa's request or question, replied specifically to your same question that you posed, that a red notice have been lodged with the Interpol and that the due process should then begin. So therefore, we'll have to await that process to take effect. Be that as it may, now, I'm not going into the politics of it. You see, for you, there is a certain political element, so you will have to make this whole new noise. But then, responsible government, the certain actions that need to be taken have been taken. Now, if he has violated bail conditions and has not returned, and if there is a warrant out for him, then that process has to take place, that process has begun. So let us wait until the recipient state fulfills their obligations and then informs the Interpol accordingly. Then the judicial process can thereafter look after itself. Be that as it may, this question of Transfer of Offenders Act and variety of different treaties that we have signed with different states, in my opinion, should be looked at from the point of view of our own expenditure. Now, we are keeping these offenders. Most of them are serving life sentences in our prisons. Not only have they committed an offense which attracts life sentence, we are burdened with the taxpayers' money being spent on looking after these prisoners for lifetime in our prisons. And they don't even qualify for pardon, presidential pardon, even in the rare cases, because they are not our citizens. Therefore, it is much better for the foreign ministry to engage with the high commissioners and ambassadors of countries which has missions here. Now, variety of different countries. Now, I have, in my foreign trips, I have encountered several such countries where they are unaware of the number of prisoners who belong to their own citizenship, who are serving jail terms here. Similarly, there may be occasional cases of Sri Lankans serving elsewhere. So, I think we must do some proactive measures, take some proactive measures to identify the number of foreign nationals serving in our prisons. Sentences which it has to be under this act. He has to have a minimum of 1 year sentence remaining for him to be transferred. Otherwise, it's pointless for us to be taking that, laborious, maybe 6 months. I saw somewhere it was 1 year because, maybe. So, they had to have a minimum. No, the sentence had to be more than 1 year. They had to have remaining period of more than 6 months to serve in that prison. So, therefore, based on that fact, I saw from some records, there are several women prisoners. You know, in the case of drugs, sometimes it's very unfortunate. Some of these prisoners may be even unaware that they were carrying the drugs. It's a strict liability offense. You see, you're caught with the stuff and you have to say how it came into your possession. If you are unable to prove it, then you are landed for life. It's that sentence. You see, converted to life here. Then now I see our president has gone on record having said that he is going to carry out the death sentence. That has other implications internationally for us. But then quite apart from that debate relating to death sentence, this issue of trying to get rid of these prisoners, and at least from the humanitarian side, these people have kith and kin. You know, why not we make that minimum effort of informing the missions to look for their relatives and other friends, and then see whether there is a desire to get them back, and then let them serve sentences in those prisons. Because after all, we have signed these. There are several such agreements that have been signed by the Justice Ministry with other countries. But then we still have number of these prisoners languishing in our jails, and we have to pay the taxpayers' money to look after them forever. So these things have to be looked at from a much more realistic point of view. Then we also have the issue of human smuggling and human trafficking. Now our country used to be in, we were originally in the tier 2 category. Now we have been brought down to tier 3. I wonder whether we have been again elevated to tier 2. Because under the TIPS agreement, we were enjoying a better status. At least we were recognized as a country which is taking some effective action against human trafficking and human smuggling. Now there is now this issue of we must separate this between the real issue of migration. Now legal migration is one thing, illegal migration is another. But then every illegal migration doesn't amount to human trafficking or human smuggling, but that becomes a big syndicated offence. Now there are
honourable minister,
syndicates.
Honourable minister, 2 minutes more.
Yes, Mr. Deputy Chairman of Committees. Now we as a country, now there is a process called Bali process, where certain countries which are very interested in reducing the number of migrants coming and landing in their shores, like our friends the Australians, are taking some extra effort. Now the European Union faces the same problem with the Mediterranean countries. And particularly, you know, after the Syrian war and the war in Yemen, and then in northern African states, there is this large migratory pattern that is taking place. Several lives are lost in the sea. So this is a humanitarian issue. In the meantime, this collective sale of humans for a variety of different purposes, for prostitution, individuals are trafficked, and those poor women, their passports are confiscated by the gangs, and they are kept as virtual prisoners. And these issues, I know for a fact that however much we try, the conviction rate in human trafficking and human smuggling is not to a desirable level. So we cannot, because the burden of proof is such that even the Attorney General Department and the police authorities are finding it extremely difficult to get proper convictions in time. So these are dragging on indefinitely, several cases in our courts. So that being the case, it is important for us to take some effective action so that we'll get back to tier 2 and be at least be recognized as a country which is taking effective action, because we have moved as a source country to a transit country to a certain level, because our country was used as a transit point to take to engage in human trafficking across our shores to other countries. So these issues need to be tackled, and I must say the Sri Lankan Navy and particularly the Criminal Investigation Department have done a good coordinated exercise in the last few years to improve our situation when it came to human trafficking and human smuggling, and I thought these matters should be improved further. And we only heard yesterday the arrest of Markandre Madhush in Dubai, and he is supposed to be connected with so many drug offences, and these matters, suddenly there is this big zeal in trying to contain drug offences, while it is a salutary thing to be done, but we need to speed up the legal process in getting the extradition done and the prosecution to be begun, so that it will be a lesson for others who have been engaged in such serious offences. Therefore, Mr. Deputy Chairman of Committees, thank you very much.